All right. Spencer on the other side. Yo guys, you can hear me, press 1. Make sure everything is good before I start.
The fight is on.
Trying to do this without no hiccups. Good stuff.
It's do or die. Fight maximum.
Alright guys, so yeah, Spencer is actually a really hard character to learn. He seems easy, because you know, you got things like random arms that people get hit by and stuff. But it's really hard to play a solid neutral game with him because he really needs an assist to be safe. If he doesn't have an assist, like, he can't really be safe. So like, if you do things like something like that, like that's, I can get bodied. Hold on, I can what can I do against him? A 3-frame punish. And then you can just like push guard. And then that isn't safe anymore. So when you're swinging with Spencer, you always want to make sure you either get the confirm or just really just stop right here. You can confirm really with this. This string is really, really good. Jab into crouch jab. Because it's going to stop them from holding up back if you want to pressure them. And then you can see around the third hit whether you hit them or not if you want to stop or keep going. And if they block, you see them push guard, you just stop right there. You don't gotta keep going anymore. But if you're gonna swing, you really wanna go in with an assist almost at all times. Cause that way you can zip safely. If I zip like from full screen before my assist comes out, I can't get grabbed. Or they can they don't have to take the mix up. Let me see, gotta get my fingers coordinated. Like, he's gonna block. I can grab him too. Let me see if I can display that real quick. I think I'm pressing the assist too early. Because I got the timing down where I'm gonna make my zip safe all the time. But that's the key with him is being safe. Because people just zip all over the place and it's never safe when they do it. And they always get hit or grabbed, and they wonder why. Especially this zip right here, people get grabbed out of that all the time. And it's annoying seeing that, but if you're going to do something like that, just always do it behind the assist. Because that way, they have to block the assist, or they have to jump early, and they're not going to be able to punish you. You do it like that, you just do it raw, then you're going to get hit, and you're going to get bodied for it. See right there? Something like that would have been hard to deal with. You can always make your zips safe behind an assist. Or really close. Like if you do this zip is actually plus, I think. But Spencer doesn't have the fastest normal, so it's hard to take advantage of that. You can do this zip behind an assist. Overhead, start mixing up. And things like that. So, let me see. Overhead, as we all know by now, some people don't actually, but overhead is not safe. So I'm gonna try and jump out. Well, I have the computer trying to jump out. He gets grabbed. But what I see people doing a lot is this. They push guard the overhead, and then they give Spencer, they let him be safe. You don't ever want to push guard the overhead, because you can get a free punish for it. And other people, they can kill off of a grab, so something you definitely want to be careful about. with his zips, these zips, like the normal zips when he's on the ground, if you go up or pretty much any direction, I can slant and go straight up, go down. After I zip like this, I'm at super jump height. But since I never super jump technically, I can call assist while I'm in the air. So if you have a good assist, like Plasma Beam is good for that, or Dante up close. I can zip up, call jam session when I'm in the air. I can come down and mix them up if they didn't move by then. And something like that is really good to know. Can you just jab him out of overhead? If your jab is fast enough, your jab has to be 4 frames or less. He's only minus 4 on block. But it's always unsafe to grabs. So grab it is a universal punish for that everybody can do. Nah, he's not minus 2. Yeah, he's definitely minus 4. Minus 4 a little more. There's something actually really important that I want to show. It's mainly his combos, how they work. I'm gonna start with after supers, because a lot of people have trouble with getting the extra up grapple after supers. They don't really understand how to do the zips properly. So I'm gonna do a regular combo. So there's 2 ways to do this. I'm gonna show both ways. There's this way. It's the way that I do all the time, because it's the most consistent on every character. And then there's the zigzag way. And then you up grapple there. Now, the difference between the two, if you notice, one is a super jump TK, and the other is a normal jump TK. Now, the reason why this is important is because it changes how they fall after the zips. So now I'm going to do a zigzag on a normal jump, and you see the difference. He fell faster than if I do it on a super jump. So, what you want to do is, since after supers, normal jump TK into straight diagonal and then straight down is usually the most consistent way. But you want to do it off of a normal jump. So during the super, so that you don't accidentally get a super jump and then try and do straight diagonal and then straight down. I'm gonna show you what happens when you do that in a super jump. See, they don't fall as fast, so it's hard to get the straight down afterwards. The problem with the zigzag is there's too many different body types in the game to make it consistent. Everybody has like different hitbox in their lower body, so sometimes you're gonna get the first zip, of course, and then you might not get the second zip, or they're gonna fall in front of you instead, and it's gonna make it inconsistent. So what you do is, like, during the super, I'll show you the whole cinematic super. During the whole animation, just hold down. That way when you do the TK motion, you're always going to get a normal jump, no matter what. And you'll always get that consistently. It even works on it. I think it works on Raccoon. Let me give myself some meter. It's a little harder on him because he still is a little body, but... yeah, that definitely still works on Rocket Raccoon. But you'll probably never get the zigzag on Raccoon. Yeah, because he's too small. You'll hardly ever get that on Raccoon. So when you do supers, always do normal jump TK, so that way you can do the diagonal and the down zip. Now combos. Everybody knows his combos by now. They're pretty standard, but what you want to do is mainly corner carry on all his combos. I don't, because I usually get mid-screen kills with my team, but... it's a perfect corner carry. No matter where you are on the screen, I think it's going to corner carry. I missed the up grab. And then there's also this one. And now a corner carries, definitely from corner to corner. And with this combo, what I learned actually last night, that I'll start doing more, it's easier to get this when you delay this S right here. Because that way, when you do this zip, they're higher. So that way you can get the whole sequence of zips. And then always get the corner carry from it. Little things like that, it'll make it a lot easier when you do your combos. Cause that's the hardest thing with him, is knowing the specs of all his combos. And like this problem right here with Spencer. This is called Spencer stuff. When you don't know if you're able to get the air S after the diagonal zip or not. This is a problem that I'm pretty sure every Spencer player goes through. But it's something that you'll almost never know because of different body types and just Spencer stuff. I don't even know how to explain it because I don't know how it works 100%. What else can I show you guys? Starting combos with Crouch H is good because it's a quick low that reaches. See, if you're playing footsie and you dash back low, you can't do it with Crouch Light. So you can go into Crouch H and zip, and then you still get it confirmed. The only thing is, as I mentioned before, if they push block the Crouch H and you do that, then you're open for punish. So always do that behind assist. So I do it behind Plaza Beam. I still get it confirmed all the time. Spencer really shines with a beam assist. So if you're gonna play Spencer, I recommend not playing him as anchor number one, because I hate seeing Spencer anchor. And have a beam or any type of horizontal assist, because they really help him a lot when he has trouble getting in. Bionic Arm, we all know, is invincible. In case you're in a Spencer mirror, always know that the second arm always wins, no matter what. So if you're playing chicken with your opponent and he does arm, you're doing things like that, the second arm is always gonna win. Be careful in that mirror, because it's a funny mirror. One thing that's also really good to do, random straight zips, because now that the metagame has evolved, you see a lot of people plink dashing all over the place. And you never know if you can just catch them slipping or not. Just one random zip can ruin their day. And then you get a full combo confirmed. See, Spencer stuff just happened. It's hard to control. Random zips are always good, because they're pretty safe from about, I want to say, 75% of the screen. Like, about right there is pretty safe. Oh, not even. Yeah, right here. I didn't block low. But about 75%. And also, you can do it behind an assist, too, and get the full combo. But you might have to reel him in. You call him behind the assist. Get the full combo. Let me look in the chat real quick, see if I see any questions. If you guys have any questions pertaining to Spencer, I won't answer any other questions right now. But don't be afraid to stop me. Has to be only about Spencer. His corner combos. So you're gonna be in the corner a lot with Spencer. So it's really good to set no max damage combos. So right there, 678 before bar. At max scaling, Bionic Arm does 125k, and I think Bionic Maneuvers does 191. So that would have killed about 850. And then after you use the wall bounce, Spencer can get a pretty good mix up. Because the thing is, after you do TKH grapple, when you already use the wall bounce, this roll right here is untechable. So you pretty much get a free overhead and an assist call. And the reason I get the assist call is because I did a normal jump TK. And then you can start mixing them up from there. They can't forward roll out of the corner, so that's the best time really to mix them up. So let me just use my wall bounce real quick. Show you what I was talking about. See, now I'm gonna super jump TK right here, and I pressed assist with medium at the same time, and the assist didn't come out because it was a super jump TK. So always in the corner, you want a normal jump TK. That way it gives you an assist, and your combo just becomes easier. So with this particular combo, you want to hit their leg. The second H always has to hit their leg, and the first H has to be early when they're going up. Yeah, hit his ankles so that way I can get the first up grapple. Alright, press playback by accident. And also, you can't do that combo if you start with crouch ABC. The H, for whatever reason, has to be a standing H. Spencer's Bionic Arm versus Nova's H Centurion Arts. Bionic Arm wins, 100%. I don't even have to try that. So if I do the same combo, the C, hold on. There's a way I think wasn't supposed to work. Yeah. I wonder how I got that to work. I never got that to work. But what you want to do is when you get crouch ABC, you can do that, and you can still get the up grapple confirmed. Plus continue the combo. That's the one that I do most of the time, because it's the easiest to confirm. And the damage is going to be about the same. It's 647 before bar, as opposed to 650 or 660. No, H Centurion Arts beats projectiles. Does not beat physical attacks. Now, when Spencer, in the case that Spencer is solo, because it's going to happen every now and then, because of the nature of the game, and you have meter, you might have a hard time killing. So, max damage Spencer combo, you're going to build another bar. Ooh, I missed TK. I suck. Let me explain how this works too. So I used my ground bounce already. Yo, I can't. Wow, I suck. Normally you can't do two bionic bombers in one combo because that'll happen. They'll flip out because you use the wall bounce. I mean ground bounce. However, if you back up for some reason, and you do it, it gets like, I think, like infinite ground bounce properties. I gotta do it just enough. Wow, I'm the worst player in the world. I'll try one more time. There we go. He gets infinite ground mouse properties for whatever reason. And also, I'll show you one other thing. Biotic maneuvers, in case you guys didn't know. As you see, I got a third ground bounce. Biotic maneuvers resets Spencer's ground bounce. Similar to Dante's Skydance resetting ground bounce, Spencer's Bionic Maneuvers, for some reason, resets ground bounce too. Which is good to know, in case you guys have him with Virgil, and you guys want to do loops, your ground bounce is reset, you get fresh loops. Oh, I forgot to do the super. Okay, so, max damage, Spencer. You're going to want to use every bar you got. He's still not gonna be able to kill someone like Thor. I missed the super at the end, but that would have did 1.12. Oh yeah, I also want to point out, you can only do 3 supers if you do the normal jump TK at that particular zip sequence. So once again, always normal jump TK. I can't stress how important that is. Did I miss again? No, I didn't. Alright, so let's see how much damage that does. Plus, a small mix-up after. You get 1141. And you get a small mix-up because they can't forward tech out of the next TK grapple. And the wall bounce is gone. So after you use a wall bounce, there's a few mix-ups you can do. See, I did normal jump TK and I had to realize that. I mean, super jump. So you can go for quick overhead, right? Or you can do a lot of cool things. Oh, see, I did it too high. That's another thing also. If you do it too early, like if you're doing something like this, you want to wait for them to fully hit the floor first. Because that does affect how the TK is going to come out. See, I grabbed him while he was bouncing. So I grabbed him when he's a little higher. And it messed up my zip. So you can fake out with Air H or Air S. So when you fake out, you can just go for a quick low. Or you can probably just go for a command grab. If you think they're gonna flinch because they saw you press a button. Little tricks like that are always good to know. You always wanna keep your opponent on their toes. You always mix up your options. And if you have an assist, it gets even worse. See, they would have been stuck because of jam session. And I could have went straight down if they tried to dash out. If I do a straight zip, I'm going to go behind them. Things like that. Always mix up your options with Spencer. If he's solo, it's a little harder. But if he has an assist, then it's a lot more confusing for your opponent. Yeah, man, Spencer's a crazy character. I also want to point out one button that you're going to be using a lot is this button right here, Air H. Air H is one of the best buttons in the game because the hitbox is so crazy. It hits while he's going up, cross up. See if I can make a cross up. and then he can cancel it on whiff and hit. So it's really good. It's a really good button, especially behind an assist. It's air H dash up, and it's good on defense too. Like if you see, I wish I had Magneto, but if you see Magneto try dashing, I'm gonna put him in real quick. I don't need Spencer on the other side anymore. But if you see Magneto try dashing everywhere, you can always just jump back air H. That's what I do a lot when I play Ray Ray. If you guys see when Spencer's on point, I don't need Raccoon anymore either. I'm gonna put Hagger and let me see who has 5 points durability. Nah, I'll put Doom. Again, guys, I am winging this tutorial. Nothing is written down for me or planned or anything like that. That's why it's probably kind of slow. But this is my first time doing something like this, especially with Spencer. But it's something people really need, because I want to see more Spencers. He's a fun character to watch, in my opinion. So, Magneto. Magneto just going crazy, try dashing. You get OS grab, and then if he doesn't hit you, you get air H into a confirm. Especially if you have someone like Dante. Look at that! What did I hit? Yeah, see, that button is really good. It's better defensively. But it's even better offensively, because you can set up fuzzy guards with it too. So if I were to do, let's see, blocks overhead, he had to block the air H also. So that button is really good, and jump jab is also a very good button as well. Put in the jump, because you can get really good confirms. See, like what I do a lot to people is I usually dash to them, and then I either jump back H or jump back jab, because people like to jump, they like to go up back and this and that. So it's a really good option, because you can always just special cancel and call assist with it. So that was jab into zip, right? So if I do that behind like a jam session, I get a full combo for it. Which is really, really good to know. Let me check the chat for any more questions. So you guys don't have any questions. I'm actually almost done. I'm gonna go over super jump confirms and team super stuff also. And we might be done for today. So super jump confirms, they're not all that difficult with him, but they get difficult when they're like mid screen like this. It's really hard to do, because you have to time the zips so that they don't go under like that. And things like that can happen too. Like the first zip will hit properly and the second one won't. And you can delay it too much and it'll go over. So you wanna be extra careful when you're doing it. And you can always do that. Definitely an easier confirm. In the corner, it's a lot easier. You can do. I think you get Bionic Bomber too. Let me make sure. Oh no, you don't. Let me wait. You might be able to get B into S. nah, you can't. But what I do, I don't really know about that, because what I do is just raw tag. I usually just raw tag Doom after I get super jump confirmed. But the mid-screen ones are the ones that are really hard. The best combo you can get off a plasma beam, it depends on where it hits. And if it, like, started the combo. Super jump confirms with Spencer is definitely something I think everyone should practice, because there's a lot of different scenarios that you're gonna be in, and you want to know what to do in each one. See right there, that was a super jump back H. And you want to know things like that. When is the zip gonna go under him? It has to hit like the middle of his body. Not even the middle of his body. Probably like his head. For him not to go under him. And that's what's hard. And you can always do that. And you get a full confirm if you do like air S. So things like that, very important to practice. I'm not that great at them, but I always raw tag Doom. So, but if I don't have that option, I might be screwed. So definitely practice some of these super jump confirms. It's usually going to be air H into S and then diagonal zips. And like I said, it's harder when they're like this in the middle of the screen, but when they're at the edge of the screen, it's a lot easier. Let me stop super jumping, put them to the edge. Because Spencer is almost automatically gonna stop when he's at the edge of the screen. A good Spencer team is, I think the best Spencer team is what I have right now, is Spencer Doom Dante. Because he has a beam assist, which is something that he needs. And then Jam Session and Spencer is really good for mix-up potential, and also controlling, you know, the super jump space, because he's always going to be able to get the confirm at super jump height with Dante. So it's definitely a very strong team. I never went over that particular super ender. So sometimes they're gonna be a little far away. You might not feel like dashing up. So what you would do is a super jump medium TK, and I'm gonna show you why you would super jump in that situation. Falls too far. He either falls too fast, or the combo will deteriorate differently. See right there, I did three, and this S didn't hit him. So if I do three here, it should hit. Hopefully, I don't look like a fraud. Because the hitstun deterioration is slightly, there's slightly more of it, not more, there's slightly less hitstun deterioration when you super jump as opposed to normal jumping. So in that instance, when you're too far away, and sometimes it'll be like that when you hit bionic maneuvers, I think a little too far away, you'll have to do super jump with medium. Because you can't dash up fast enough. Let me see if I can get that real quick. So that's really the only time that you want to use super jump TK. When you see that you use too much hit stun, and when you're not directly in the corner. Other than that, you probably won't ever really use super jump TK. Unless you're just really used to zigzag, but like I said, against certain characters, zigzag into up grapple does not work consistently, or it doesn't work at all. But if you saw earlier, I got it to work on Rocket Raccoon. So it pretty much works on everybody. I want to also say one thing. One very important trick with Spencer. So normally, he's falling and he's recovering, right? Let me put him in the block. I didn't put him in the block. So I can't do anything. I'm falling, right? But Spencer, he's able to dash. If it's a just frame timing, but it's able to keep you safe from just straight falling and not being safe at all. So it's something really good to know. It uses an air action. So if I do I can do two more zips. Or if I do zip and then grapple, I get one more zip. Things like that. You can switch it up. But it's really important for that, because sometimes you might catch them slipping in the air. Get the super jump confirmed. And sometimes they might just block, and you don't want to get punished. Let's see if I can get a confirm from this. So that's really good to know. You can zip out of any air grapple that you do, on whether it whiffs or if they block. Yeah, Drekker, I was just hoping that I landed the just frame timing when I mashed it. Which I did, so leave me alone. So, one last thing I'm going to show you guys. Actually, I'm going to show you two more things. One is command grab combo, which is pretty much the same combo. See, so you guys can see max damage from command grab. This is solo, I'm not going to use any assists. So with two bars, Spencer gets about 900. So 898 for two bars off of a command grab. And mid-screen, go into loops. Wow. The loop combo isn't going to do a lot of damage, but the main thing is just getting into the corner. And you only get one rep if you do this particular loop. So you want to make sure, if you're going to do that one, you do that towards the end of the combo. Because you can't get two reps of that. He's going to keep falling out. What you can do, if you already committed to that, you can do that, and that way you get your corner carry. Because the thing about Spencer teams is that they're always going to be able to kill you when they're in the corner, no matter what. So since I have Dante, I have team super option. Actually, two bars. Let me just fix my order. Oh. So any Spencer-based team should always be able to kill in the corner. That's definitely a priority. You always want to be able to kill. If you can't kill mid-screen, you want to be able to kill in the corner. Because Spencer, he can get a bunch of supers, and he pretty much dominates the corner because he can keep their opponent there. Now, since I already did the team super, Team Super with Spencer is, for me, it's a part of his neutral game. So if you do have assists, we put him on all block. You get a free mix-up from Team Super. So they're forced to block that, and they can't push guard. Because they'll be push guarding. Plasma, I'll still be in their face. It's always really good. With Doom, I think if you do it up close, it's a little less safe. But still, you still get the same mix-up. No, mashing during THC does not add any hits. Because Spencer's the primary character and there's nothing to mash. Mix-ups with Dante, Team Super. I haven't found anything overly cheap yet. I'm sure I will soon, but... since they do have to block a lot. You can pretty much just keep pressuring them until you see that you hit them. You don't want to be obvious with it, because everybody's going to go low and then overhead, you know, things like that. Just don't be obvious with the pressure. And you want to also realize that there is a gap. So, the gap is when the bullets stop. So you wanna recognize that they can and most likely will jump because they don't want to take any more mix-ups past that point. So definitely be careful with how you try and mix up. For now, I think I'm gonna stop it here. What I wanted, basically what I wanted to show was that there's a lot of specific things with Spencer. As I explained with the difference in super jump zipping and normal jump zipping, I feel like things like that are extremely important because that way you know how to end your combos properly. So, just definitely be careful which kind of zip you do, and always remember to hold down, hold the down direction